If you just type 300, you notice the default stroke is free, the default type is swim, and the default intensity is moderate. You can set your own default intensity either before or while you're writing the workout. You also see that the set's going to take 4 minutes and 30 seconds, and that's based off of the default 100 pace time, which you can also set before writing the workout. If I add some extra details to this, let's say we're going to do 2 reps of it, the interval will be 5 minutes, we'll do a kick, and we'll build each 300. The data updates instantly based on that extra detail. So writing a set is as easy as typing out a reps number, a distance, an interval, and a description, which can be as long and creative as you want. Let's look at a few examples. Here we have 6 100s on 125, odds, sprint, evens, easy. You'll see how Commit's algorithm can understand things like odds and evens. And that's why we have 300 sprint and 300 easy for the 600 yard set. Here we have 1250s, 1 through 4 kick on the minute, 5 through 8 paddle pull on 55, and 9 through 12 swim on 50. And each component of that set is getting appropriately recognized. If you type something like 300 choice, 50 drill, 25 swim, again, Commit's algorithm can understand descriptions like this, and the appropriate distance will get assigned to drill and to swim. If you don't include a distance and just want to say 6 minutes of easy swimming, focus on technique, then a distance will be implied based off of the default 100 pace time that you set. Here, you'll notice the description is in brackets. That's because if you don't include brackets, this set will get recognized as a kick set. That's because Commit's algorithm is seeing the word kick in the description. When you use brackets, you block the algorithm from trying to interpret anything inside them. So here, kick is getting ignored because it's inside brackets. So now, this set is getting recognized as a swim set. And if you type drill at the end here, outside of the brackets, it changes to drill. You can also type 2 minutes rest, and that's going to add 2 minutes to the total workout time. Let's say I want each of these sets to be kick. Rather than writing kick 3 times, I can just create a header, call it kick set, and then indent these individual sets inside of this header. Now, even though individually these sets would get recorded as swims, since they're indented inside of a header that has the word kick in it, all 350 yards is getting recorded as kick. This is really helpful with anything. If you just want to write a warm-up, you can do 100 drill, 100 choice. Now normally, my default intensity is moderate, but since it's indented inside of a header called warm-up, these 200 yards are getting recorded as easy swimming. This is also how you write a circuit. So if you want to repeat something 3 times through, you just type 3x, hit enter, and then here you can type whatever you want, 100 IM, 100 pull. Normally, this would just get recorded as 100 yards, and this get recorded as 100 yards, but since they're indented inside of this 3x, it's a total of 600 yards. Now you can get creative and do indentations inside of indentations. So we can indent this circuit, say it's all part of the warm-up. Now we have this warm-up, which includes 100 drill, 100 choice, and this circuit of 100 IM and 100 pull. And that's why you see the data getting correctly recorded here based on those indentations. If you're a coach that trains multiple groups at once, you can use group tags to designate sets to that specific group. Let's assume that you're training a distance group and a sprint group within this workout. You'll notice there's a difference in 400 yards here, and that's because everyone is doing the 400 yard warm-up since there's no group designation. But here we have a hashtag sprint, and indented we have an extra 650s and 100 yards that's associated to this group. If we want to write sets for the distance group, we just have to do shift 3 to bring up the pound sign, select distance, and now you can write a set. So we can do something like 500 paddle pull. And you'll see how the data instantly updated. So the distance group is now doing 900 yards, the sprint group is doing 800, and it's going to take about the same time. Again, indentation is important. So if you just back this out, now this 100 yards is going to get applied to both the distance and the sprint group, since it's technically not indented inside of sprint. So if you only want this 100 yards to be part of the sprint group, make sure you hit tab so it's indented inside of sprint.